Well, blessed morning, friends and folks. Today is November 3rd. So let's dive right into this lesson. This one is called Just Like Jesus, and the scripture that we have is 1 John 2:6. Whoever claims to live in him must walk as Jesus did. We have a quote from a man named Thomas Brooks. A believer's life should be nothing but a visible representation of Christ. Simple. In words, the beginning. It seems obvious, but somehow we miss this truth. We who claim salvation by faith in Jesus, that we are fulfilled with the Holy Spirit of God and worship our Father in spirit and in truth, are often remarkably unlike our Savior. What causes such incongruity in our lives? Do we want only the benefits of salvation without its responsibilities? I believe that's a once saved, always saved method of philosophy there. Do we grab the free spirit of grace while forgetting the cross-carrying side of discipleship? James Baker and I, we carry crosses. Like, really, we carry crosses. That means a lot right there. Whatever our reasons, we are not alone. Every religion has adherents who claim to follow its precepts, but are noticeably indifferent to them. Believers are adept at such games as well. We fool ourselves into thinking that agreement with the gospel equals living it, but it doesn't. You know, of course, we have to read the word. We have to use it out here in this world. I'm going to send my babies a good text to tell them I love them very much. And I thank them because they have the Lord Jesus in their hearts. And when my flesh wants to rise, usually because of anger. Now, I know anger gives a foothold to the devil, but I am a dumb flesh being. A big dumb meathead sometimes. When my flesh rises up, them girls always put it out. And I'll look at them and I'll still be mad, like hulking out, you know. But they'll shut me up because I know that the beatitude needs to envelop the attitude. My girls are so sweet in the Lord that they show me his beatitude. And it always follows my attitude. And I tell them, forgive me, babies. And they always do. They see me forgive a lot. Perhaps as John wrote this sentence, he was recalling the sharp words of Jesus when he asked his disciples, oh, we fool ourselves into thinking that agreement with the gospel equals living it, but it doesn't. Perhaps as John wrote the sentence, he was recalling the sharp words of Jesus when he asked his disciple a penetrating question. Why do you call me Lord, Lord, and you do not do what I say? John has seen crowds surround the miracle-working Jesus with admiration and even worship, and he had also seen them walk away when the teaching got tough. Are we only miracle seekers as well? Oh, do we seek a salvation that doesn't disrupt our lives? Do we claim to live in him and yet not live like him? Indeed, the conclusion. 1 John was written to help believers know whether their faith was genuine or not. High on the list of indicators for authenticity is a consistent lifestyle. John tells us, in essence, that there is no such thing as a Christ-like believer. He acknowledges our imperfections and our need to confess, of course, but he never implies that we can claim saving faith without a serious regard for the way we live. We must be like him. Students resemble their teachers. Servants resemble their masters. Children resemble their parents. And believers, children of God, resemble Christ. It's a given. Devote all diligence to this truth. The watching world is skeptical of the faith because it has seen unchristlike believers. God's word calls his witness to be like him. Wow. I do the best that I can. I know I need sharpening up, but there's no such thing as a perfect man in this world. But who is perfect as the Son of Man, Jesus himself? Even my girls that quench my fires, they make mistakes. But the fire that burns in a child's heart is more pure than us. Us as adults, we commit foolishness and know that we shouldn't sometimes. But when we return to being a child of God and we ask him to forgive us as our high priest, we're right back where we need to be, and we learn a lesson from it. and we try to apply the instruction of His Word, because it's the basic instructions before leaving Earth, so that we have the benefit of His way higher than our ways. Children, they don't have to do that because they have a pure heart. They don't think no kind of evil way. They don't let their flesh rule them. What they do is they let the Spirit rule them of the Lord. And with all that being said, no, you serve God that is alive and not dead. You have a blessed day today. Adios.